I please ask you to join with me as we welcome Dr. Tony Karam to the stage. This is unbelievable.
I'm behind you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for being here. I can't thank you enough. I'm not going to add too many words to everything that was said. Thank you. I got it. So we'll make this a little bit informal. I'll try to explain to you some things before I play them. But before we start, and before I tell you about the program, I'm going to play something that kind of symbolizes this unity that we're feeling tonight between Lebanon and the U.S. It starts out with what we feel Lebanon is like today, then it goes to the United States, then it brings us back to the real Lebanon. We'll start our program. You have the program with you. This program, the pieces in it, I've picked them specifically for this concert tonight. They have some symbolism to them. Next to every piece, you'll see an artwork. The program was donated by one of our artists, Ms. Zena Nader, who's here with us tonight. She was inspired by this specific music to draw these. So this is for your entertainment. I'll start with a piece that was transcribed by Bach. These are rare. They're not too often that you find Bach transcribing for others. But it kind of portrays this general mood that we're in Beirut.
Thank you.
little bit more fun. Next piece, Baiba, was transcribed by Alexander Silotti. It's a small piece, but it's played twice, and every single time you play the same notes, but you hear it differently. Sort of like our lives in Beirut. Every day is different, although we use the same streets. Moving on to Chopin, I'm going to play three pieces by Chopin. Chopin was a rebel. He broke all the rules without really going over. We'll start with an etude. It's dubbed as the Bees because, well, you'll find out why. Next piece is a nocturne also by Chopin. In September 1939, when Poland was being hit by the Nazis, This was the last piece that was played on the Polish radio, and they kind of looped it over, and that was the last thing that people heard in Poland. Well, we've been hit hard in Beirut. That's why it was chosen. Thank you. Now the real Chopin. This ballad was criticized by his fellow composers, but not criticized in a negative way, but rather by a positive review, and they actually dubbed it as the most complete piece. It talks straight to the heart, yet it's technically challenging.
Thank you.
So it keeps getting better. Friends list. The name itself says it all. One of the most acclaimed pianists before he was a composer. Then he combined composing with being a pianist, and he was a talent. One of his most famous pieces, Hungarian Rhapsody number 2, I picked it specifically because this was one of the first pieces I played for John Morris 30 years ago. So this kind of brings it back together. Of course, you all know it from the cartoon series, Tom and Jerry, so you can read about it in the program.
Thank you.
Hi again. We'll make this a brief intermission. So let's continue with the program. Franz Liszt transcribed this piece by Schubert. He was one of the composers who composed the most beautiful melodies. And then came Horowitz, the famous pianist, who transcribed it again, and then I added a couple of things to it. So let's hope you like it. Thank you.
Thank you. The next two pieces are by Abdurrahman Al-Basha, a Lebanese composer, pianist. He's a friend, and he composed these pieces. I'm gonna play them back to back, so I won't stop between both of them. The interesting thing about the first one is that way back, Chopin had wrote a piece of music that was complete from A to Z, meaning it followed all the rules, but it was the shortest piece ever written. It was only 12 bars. He did the same thing. So I'll play it twice, and then we'll move to the second piece, which was composed as a dedication to friends of his who lost their daughter. She sank in the swimming pool. So it kind of reminded me of how we feel in Beirut. Next three pieces, well, you might read in the program that they're mine. They're actually inspired by melodies I've heard, and I kind of transcribe them and add to them. The first one was inspired by a tune in Barcelona. The second one was inspired by a tune in Paris when I was there with my beautiful wife. So obviously, she's the source of inspiration. And the third one is actually a transcription from a piece that was written as an orchestra with guitar. I think you all know it. It has been used by Lebanese composers who also transcribed it to a piece by the famous Feirouz.
Thank you.
Thank you. Concerto for guitar transcribed to the piano. For the Lebanese in the audience, this was the Beirut. Okay. Now the real concert starts, Rachmaninoff. I'll start with a small piece by Rachmaninoff, which sort of combines sadness, but not to the point of depression, with sort of a hope kind of a melody that goes within it. Following that, I'll play one of his preludes, which kind of moves us to the technical portion of the program. Thank you. So there was this rivalry between Rachmaninoff and Prokofiev as to who can compose the more technically difficult piece without compromising melody. You heard Rachmaninoff will play, Prokofiev then will vote.
Thank you.
Rachmaninoff or Prokofiev? Actually, we'll end with the number one most difficult piano piece ever written. If you Google that, I'm not kidding you, just put most difficult piano piece, you'll get the Campanella by Franz Liszt. It actually doesn't look that difficult, but it is, because you gotta hit all the notes. Cindy Morris, that's for you. The Rhapsody was for John, this was played for Cindy. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Tony Karam.
Thank you.
Would we like one more?
Okay. Make it quick. Since you voted Prokofiev,